Live from ORDOS, Inner Mongolia, China, the 62nd Miss World Final!
Brazil, Bolivia, Equatorial Guinea, Bonaire, Curaçao, Gibraltar, Northern Ireland. Argentina, Chile, Bahamas, Bermuda, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Croatia, Hong Kong, China, Macau, China. Austria, Belgium, Gabon, Côte d'Ivoire, Finland, France, Colombia, Venezuela, Barbados, St. Kitts and Nevis, Aruba, Belize, Scotland, South Africa, Cyprus, Greece, Malta, Lebanon, Sweden, Indonesia, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, Ethiopia, Jamaica, India, Canada, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, Hungary, Slovenia, Uruguay, Nicaragua, Montenegro, Ireland. Italy, Albania, Germany, Norway, Japan, Philippines, Spain, Costa Rica, Trinidad and Tobago, US Virgin Islands.
Mexico, Panama, Denmark, Israel, Mongolia, four. Honduras, New Zealand, Malawi, People's Republic of China, Singapore, Kazakhstan, Belarus, Suriname. Kenya,
Serbia, Macedonia, Martinique, Guyana, Latvia, Lithuania, Seychelles. Paraguay, Portugal, Mauritius, Guadeloupe, England, Iceland, Korea, Thailand, Fiji, Guam, Guatemala, El Salvador, Malaysia, Vietnam, Tanzania, Uganda, Slovakia, Czech Republic, Turkey, Australia, Zimbabwe, South Sudan, Peru, Puerto Rico, Poland, Netherlands, Russia, Ukraine, Botswana, Bulgaria, Georgia,
ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your hosts for Miss World 2012, Mylene Klass, Lily Liu, Jason Cook, and Mongolia's favorite host, Ni Ramto.
Thank you. at Dongsheng Stadium in the city of ORDOS, China, and this is Miss World 2012. 116 countries competing for the most coveted crown in beauty.
Wow, 116 nations, that has smashed last year's record. So a big thank you to the city of ORDOS as our host this year. ORDOS is in Inner Mongolia, an autonomous region of China. The city's name derives from the Mongolian for many palaces, so it is quite appropriate to crown the new Miss World here.
You're not just a pretty face, are you? Every day is a school day. Now, we are also joined by Lily Liu from CCTV and Inner Mongolia's favorite host, Naramto. Hiya, guys.
Hello, and thank you for the introduction. Well, 谢谢各位来到世界小姐2012全球总决赛的现场。 今天晚上在美丽的鄂尔多斯，我们将迎来来自全球116个国家和地区的佳丽们。
好，那 欢迎大家。 에헤무주시드 타브쿤 삼바시카노 어다 타브쿤의 아스튼 메드메이드 터트르조가보드 논두도싱 어르도 서트 디아보드조가 허이르맨 가루와 허이르네 디드킨 거후회초디 샤바로드띵 시드르틈쯤 버드키마
화이르타 쉐쉐 Thank you, Marlene. So last year, we saw the introduction of the very popular Miss World scoreboard. So here to explain how it all works is events director Steve Douglas.
Oh, so here's how it works. The highest marks from our pre-judging and six special events will determine who goes through to tonight's semi-final. Now, the live scoreboard will update throughout the evening and show the current scores. And you can follow the placing of all 116 contestants on our website, missworld.com. At present, every country has a zero score. But as soon as the first results from pre-judging are in, we'll reveal our first leaderboard. So stay with us.
After the break, the first fast track. Don't go away.
Welcome back to ORDOS, Dongsheng, and the contestants' first meeting with the judges. Very important. Now, making a good impression is vital, as the pre-judging process accounts for almost 30% of the total marks. So, a high score here could effectively make all the difference.
Let's see how the contestants got on.
At the age of 15, I got onto the Irish Olympic squad.
I've served overseas in Afghanistan.
I study pharmacy at Queen's University.
I'm studying graphic design.
I'm a student in psychology.
In nuclear medicine, studied history, philosophy.
I hope to work as a lawyer in the infant welfare center.
I'm currently a nurse.
I am studying to become a doctor.
For children having chronic diseases of kidneys.
I was bullied from grade 7, 8, 9, up to grade 10.
I was involved in a very serious accident. And I was paralyzed from the neck down. I couldn't walk. I nearly died.
2 years ago, I have operation for my back, so I have scars because I have scoliosis.
My project was with HIV positive women because my grandma was infected.
I'm sorry. I've always been really close with my mom. When I was 12, she had a heart surgery and she got her valve replaced. When I was 16, it's when we kind of lost everything.
Whenever anyone would come up to me and say, so what do you want to become in life? Two things, I want to be an engineer and I want to be a Miss India, and Miss World seemed too big to me.
And at age 17, I competed in my first international track and field competition. And I placed first and set a new record.
If you can make the life of others a little bit better, then you're making your life better.
We're always laughing. There's no part of the day where we are like sad and stressed. We always find the littlest things to laugh about to make our day even more.
My father and mother was both farmer. They hope me and my sister can go to school.
I know everybody says this, but my parents are the best. They give us everything.
This year has been, I don't know, the best year of my life.
Oh my gosh, it was like the most amazing feeling of my life.
I feel like I'm part of a family here. I feel so comfortable with everyone. And when you work as a family, you achieve so much more.
I want to go far. Make it something different. Bring something different, something new. And this is why I am here.
Regardless of the outcome of Miss World, I can use my beauty with a real purpose.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
With the interviews over, let's see what the judges thought.
Wow, this is a well-educated and ambitious group of young women. We have doctors, pharmacists, psychologists, lawyers, and we even have a nuclear physicist. These contestants are not to be underestimated. Definitely my kind of ladies. So, judges, I want to know who impressed you. I'm joined here by the CEO of Miss World, Julia Morley. Hello.
Hi, Miley.
Give it up for Julia. So, Julia, they are very, very impressive. What were you looking for? What did you love about them?
We had interviews, two lots of interviews over many, many hours, and I think the thing that impressed me most, they're women, and they want to prove that they're not airheads, they're really serious about their professions. And they're fun, they're exciting, they raise a lot of money for children, and I think all around I'm very proud of them.
Nuclear physicists, doctors, lawyers, these are not airheads in any way. How important is it that they prove that?
I think just being a secretary, anybody that does a good job or works hard is important. So we've worked with 116 nations for 5 weeks under the same roof, shared the same itinerary, and it's a great experience.
Julia, thank you very much. Steve.
Well, our first set of scores are in, so we can now see who is in the top 30. And leading away, 20-year-old Atong Damak from South Sudan. She obviously impressed the judges. She's got 167 points, closely followed by Spain and Wales. Leading the home challenge are China in 14th and Hong Kong, China in 18th place. Botswana, runner-up 2 years ago, just makes our first leaderboard in 30th place. We'll come back to you after Jason.
Thank you, Steve. We now come to the first of our 6 Miss World special events. Points are awarded for the highest-placed contestants in each event, with a maximum of 50 points awarded to the winner. Our first special event was Miss World's Top Model.
Everything here
feels like gold. I just want it all. If I could afford it, I would have it all.
Hoy es un día muy especial porque la corona Miss Mundo es un símbolo para recaudar dinero para los niños más necesitados. Y hoy, 1436, está recaudando fondos para los niños que lo necesitan. Para mí es un honor estar acá y ser invitada en un evento tan importante como este. Estoy sumamente feliz. Gracias por todo.
Having raised an amazing 260,000 yuan for a local primary school, the contestants attend an exclusive catwalk event.
The Top Model Show is, of course, a well-awaited show here in Miss World, and we'll be wearing one of the most beautiful and luxurious cashmere brands in the world.
So today we've got this beautiful makeup, which is bringing out their features. We want bright eyes, a very soft lip. I want to show the girl looking really natural and bringing out her true beauty.
All 40 contestants are wearing handmade cashmere by renowned designer Graham Black. The girls are all model contestants, of course, but do they have what it takes to make it into the top 10? Into the final collection of the evening, and the contestants have one last chance to impress the judges. Caught the eye of the judges. Let's reveal the top 10. So, congratulations to Brazil, Australia, Spain, Mexico, also through is Chile, People's Republic of China, Poland, South Sudan, and our last two contestants, Jamaica and Belize. So there they are, our top 10 finalists.
Please welcome our 10 top finalists dressed by 1436. ORDOS is a world-famous cashmere-producing region, and what a stunning cashmere collection by Graham Black. So, the winner of Top Model is... South Sudan! Well done. So, Steve, we know the top model, but who's top of the scoreboard now?
Well, I think it's going to be obvious because in front after pre-judging was South Sudan. So with South Sudan winning top model, she has extended her lead to 19 points. Mexico was third in top model, and this now moves her into second place overall on 198 points. But our big mover on the leaderboard this time is Poland, whose second place in top model moves her from 26th all the way up to fourth in the overall standing. But that will all change maybe after the break, when we announce the winners of three more events.
After the break, live music from a 50-piece string band, plus more fast-track events. Stay tuned.
special. You're going to be hearing from a special music instrument from Inner Mongolia, and it's called... Yes, the horse cello. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy that.
Those guys rock. Wow. Okay, so now, I just wear any old pair of trunks to the beach, but our contestants, they're a little more style conscious. The breathtaking seven-star lake and the ringing dunes was a setting for our next event, Beach Fashion.
All 116 contestants are taking part in our 2012 Beach Fashion section, which will be the most spectacular ever. Getting the best results won't be easy, so the girls set off from the Seven Star Lakes Hotel at 4 a.m. for a photo shoot on the golden sands at the edge of the Kabuchi Desert. It's going to be a long, hot day, and while the girls are working, our judges will be drawing up a short list of 40 top models, which will then be cut down to just 10. So, the pressure is on, and despite the heat, they have just one chance to impress. Can't afford to put a foot wrong. As the photo session draws to a close, the judges have chosen their top 10. Let's find out who the finalists are. time to name the winner.
Right, sorry. Unfortunately, there can only be just one. So the winner of Beach Fashion is... Wales. Well done, Wales. All right, Mylene, where are you out there?
I'm here. I'm hiding. I had a dress change. Oh, yes. Now, social networking has massively transformed the way that we interact with one another. And this year, Miss World has introduced an exciting new social media award. The contestants were tasked with creating an online following by posting stories, photographs, and fun updates to share their life-changing Miss World experiences with their fans right across the globe. Now, we're joined by the 10 multimedia finalists, but two contestants really did catch the eye of our judging panel. I can now tell you, they are... Mexico and India! Well done, you guys. Now, I'm joined here by one of our judges, musical director Mike Dixon. Hello, Maestro. How are you this evening?
I'm very good, Mylene. How are you?
Very good. Nice bow tie. Nice touch. Now, what were you looking for when you were judging social media and these girls in particular?
Well, as a Twitterati myself, I think it's so important that these young girls embrace all this new modern technology. And India and Mexico did take the biscuit. They really, really...
Why? What did they do? Tell us.
Well, they just seemed to embrace... They took hold of this new thing, you know, with the Miss World website, and they ran with it brilliantly.
They made it fun, engaged with their fans. Well done, girls. Okay, well, the time is nigh. Our winner of social media is... India! Well done, India. Steve.
Well, two events to look at here, and with Wales taking the beach beauty title, 50 points moves her back into fourth place. And the 50 points for India's win takes her from 10th up to second place. But we have a new leader as Mexico now storms into the lead on 258 points. And that's after placing second in media and being a finalist in beach fashion. But watch out, as you can see, China is steadily moving up and is now in fifth place. Over to you, Jason.
Thank you, Steve. So after being put through their paces in an exhausting sports eliminator, our top contestants battled it out at Dongsheng Stadium for the title Miss World Sportswoman.
你好吗?
It's my exercise, you do it the way I want it done.
The sports eliminator took the contestants through a rigorous selection process.
I'm glad that it is about fitness and it's not about something silly like a leg race, so it's really, really good.
And to the side of the head.
Maybe I should have spent more hours at the gym.
I tried my best, I hope I did good.
It was painful. It felt like track and field all over again.
So difficult. I don't have my voice.
The top six girls from each team secured their places in the swimming sprint event. The With the swimming results in, the team's headed for the Dongsheng Stadium for the track and field events.
What an amazing leap! The only lady to go over 4 meters is England!
I don't know how I did it, but I've won the long jump.
I've been running since I was 11 and I competed for about 6 years.
Scotland.
We're giving the girls some baton practice, so hopefully if no one drops the baton, and we come through and win again.
We run as fast as we could and we won, so reserve.
Awesome! You're awesome!
With the blue team edging ahead in the overall team title. The day's sporting events finished off with a penalty shootout competition.
Watch out, I'm still doing more.
There were 5 individual event winners, but who placed highest overall to become our champion? Miss World Sportswoman 2012 is... Sweden! Good work, Sweden. Steve.
Well, that win for Sweden takes her from 59th up to 5th place. So on our leaderboard, we can also see the ones that did well. Wales is in 4th, Northern Ireland in 8th, England in 9th, and Scotland comes into the top 30. But still out in front, Mariana Reynoso, 20-year-old student of tourism from Mexico.
Coming up, our contestants show off their musical and dancing talent and beauty with a purpose.
Next up, talent. It's quite appropriate that I'm standing here with Mylene, an incredibly gifted musician and also in a famous British pop group. Or is that just hearsay?
Oh, Jason, nice. Nice to see an American with a British sense of humor. Well done. But of course, talent plays a very important part in Miss World. Let's take a look at who made our talent final.
All our contestants have a wide range of skills and experiences. And tonight, here at the ORDOS Theatre, we're looking for those with a talent to entertain.
Tonight is the big final show, Talent.
And I'm gonna do something different for you guys.
And I hope you enjoy it.
So, wish me luck.
But now it's time for Curtain Up. And with 16 contestants competing for just 5 places, it's a nerve-wracking time for the judges and the girls. There's only room for 5 to go through. Who will they be?
Our top 5, in no particular order. Norway, the Philippines, Jamaica, Panama, and People's Republic of China.
And there you have it, 5 fabulous finalists. But who is the outright winner?
Some fabulous, unusual talents there. Gotta learn to beatbox. I can now tell you that Miss World Talent Champion 2012 is... You're gonna like this, China! China. Steve.
Well, China wins the talent, and she takes the lead in the 62nd Miss World Final. Mexico drops a second, and Jamaica second in talent moves her from 10th to 3rd place. But just hanging in there, if you look down, Indonesia in 28th place on 225 points. But the big news here is that China has hit the front.
For over 40 years, Beauty with a Purpose has been at the heart of Miss World. The idea is very simple. Use your talents to help those less fortunate.
That's right. From our 10 finalists, the top 5 contestants have been singled out by our judges for their incredible efforts.
In fifth place, Kenya. In fourth place, Indonesia. In third place, United States of America. In second place, Australia.
And the winner of Miss World 2012, Beauty with a Purpose, is... India. Congratulations, India. Let's now take a look at the inspiring work of this young lady.
And please note that the following contains some scenes which viewers may find distressing.
I happened to visit the Muktangan School here in Mumbai, where I met to the director of the organization. She took me out on a trip to the school premises, and I realized that this methodology that they have adapted to teach their children is something which is very unique. They don't just focus on imparting education, but they also focus on organic growth of their children. Another very unique feature of Muktanga that they are encouraging people from the community to come forward and educate children.
Elizabeth Meter, who runs Muktangan, invited Julia Morley and Miss World to visit the school, where she explained that its main focus has been to set up an integrated teacher training centre. The school trains mothers and young women from the local communities, initially as teacher assistants and then as primary teachers. The key to this initiative is in how it provides both educational support for the children and at the same time creates vital employment opportunities for the local community.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, so we're going to start today.
These people are not very educated themselves, but they are so very confident now. They're encouraged, most importantly, to come forward and impart education to these children.
I want to know what basically motivated you to join Tamil?
One is I have small child for that, and second, I have not completed SSC. Now I completed SSC and HSC also.
When they go back home, they can even help their children. And at the same time, they are being employed. They are becoming independent, which is something very unique and which is, I think, a great idea to go forward with. The way Muktangan handles the special children is also very touching to see. They feel like any other normal child because they're learning the same thing. They are a part of the same class group. They're interacting with them. They're sitting along with them. So, you know, you actually making them acceptable to the society.
आप लोग मुझे बताएंगे यहाँ पे किसकी तैयारी हो रही है?
ये बच्चों के लिए फ्रूट है
ना? बच्चों के लिए फ्रूट काट रहे हैं।
Muktangan also makes sure that these children are fed properly and their nutrition is taken care of. So for that, they have introduced this concept of fruit a day, and also at the same time they serve khichdi, which is a very healthy Indian traditional meal. This kind of teaching is actually doing so much good to these children that I feel so very proud that something like Muktangan is existing in my country today.
And that is what it's all about. Well done, India. Steve.
Well, Beauty with a Purpose carries 50% more points than any other of these special events. So after the break, it could all be different as we reveal the semi-finalists.
Still to come, 30 become 15, and later all our contestants in national dress. traditional Mongolian greeting includes the offering of a katag, or loosely woven silk scarf. It should be taken and placed around the neck of the visitor. Another tradition is the offering of a sip of a local drink. First stop for the girls in Inner Mongolia was the home of this ancient country's most famous ruler.
We're at the Genghis Khan Mausoleum, so we're going in to just see what they have in store for us.
Do you know we are seeing one of the most large paintings in the world of Genghis Khan history? And you can see that in all the parts is the history of Genghis Khan.
The grand spectacle of Mongolia is 206 meters long and is based on historical events. Born in the 12th century, Genghis Khan is regarded as the founding father of Mongolia and emperor of what became the largest contiguous empire in history.
He came to power by uniting the nomadic tribes of Northeast Asia, and he's a very important conqueror.
You can see here there are lots of memorials for the old king, and a lot of horses, a lot of bulls, so this is how they went to battle.
I thought he was just like more like a military guy who took over a lot of different lands, but he also actually helped his people a lot by creating a written language, which I loved.
So after seeing the Genghis Khan Mausoleum, I've learned so much and I can really see the significance of him.
Welcome back to Miss World. Well, the points have been counted, and from 116 contestants on stage with Jason, we have 30 quarter-finalists, and he will now reveal the 15 who go through to the semi-final.
Thank you, Steve. So we are about to reveal their fate. Here in my hand, I have the results. We also have an empty scoreboard at the moment, but that is all about to change as we reveal the names of the countries going through to the semi-final, and the ink is still fresh. In 15th place is India.
Indu.
Kenya, sorry.
Kenya.
Yep. In 14th place is Indonesia.
Fini.
In 13th place, Netherlands.
Holland.
In 12th place, United States.
America.
In 11th place, Philippines.
Philippines.
In 10th place, Spain.
Spain.
In 9th place, Brazil.
Brazil.
In 8th place, England.
England.
In 7th place, South Sudan.
Nam Sudan.
In 6th place,
Wales.
Wales.
In fifth place, China PR. In fourth place, Jamaica.
Yamaica.
Getting down to it now, only three places left. In third place is Australia.
Australia.
In second place is Mexico.
Mexico.
And in first place is India.
Hindu.
Let's hear it for our 15 semifinalists, folks. So the judging panel will now give their marks for stage presence and star quality to help decide who will be Miss World 2012.
After the break, all 116 contestants perform Dances of the World, and we meet again the 15 semi-finalists.
Actually do when they celebrate. Take it away, Nella.
Монголчууд бид нэр баяр нарайн болохоор хөөрдөлдөн чингэлдэж
both of them.
I totally get it. He says music is a very, very important part for the Mongolia people. They would dance and sing, and of course drink a little bit. And our next item is actually a very popular in Miss World, as the contestants is going to actually celebrate their culture in music and dances. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Dances of the World!
pasanda.
Ya la muerte pasanda.
With a purpose has inspired generations of women to use their talents in the support of those in need. Now, in the past 12 months, Julia Morley, who we met earlier, has visited projects in more than 20 countries, including a recent visit to Ghana, where she was joined by the eldest grandson of the great Nelson Mandela, Chief Mandela, who's here with me now. Good evening, sir. Now, Miss Wild's work is heavily associated with charity. How do you think that the work that these girls does makes a huge difference?
Well, Beauty with a Purpose is about working together to make a difference in the communities we live in. And these contestants have an opportunity of contributing in the communities they live in and making a difference.
It must be really exciting for you because these women have the spotlight on them and then they can do so much good with that work. How does that feel for you to be able to see that?
Well, they're really showing their capability, that beauty is not the outer self, but it's in the inner self. They wake up every day and they are driven by different challenges to overcome those issues.
So how do you feel when you see these women underestimated?
I think it's sad, and we ought to rally behind them and give them the support they need to ensure that we better the lives of people who are disadvantaged.
They do so much good. There is no underestimating these women. In fact, let's take a look at Beauty with a Purpose in action.
Beauty is not about the outer self, but it's about the inner self. It's about searching within and understanding the context that you live in.
Last year's Beauty with a Purpose winner was Stephanie Kari Kari from Ghana. And the Miss World team, accompanied by Chief Mandela, was invited earlier this year to see the work that she'd been doing. Before Stephanie's involvement, the conditions in this nursery were appallingly unhygienic.
We found kids living in the worst slums we've ever seen in the world. And these kids were in a preschool that was totally inadequate.
Through Miss World's Beauty with a Purpose, we have been able significantly to improve the conditions in the nursery, as well as, for the first time, register the children for medical treatment.
We're going to build a daycare center to help the children get good foods, books for the education, because it's basic education, and good sanitation.
I am here to support the big project, very important project, so exciting
for working with you.
Miss World is now looking at finding a suitable piece of land to construct a purpose-built facility for the children of this slum. Chief Mandela again.
That permanent structure that would be a state-of-the-art facility that will ensure that the kids in Sodom Gomorrah have a better entry into an early childhood development center.
And that is what it's all about. Thank you, Chief Mandela, and to our ladies, of course.
Great work indeed. So, folks, it is time to welcome back to our stage the final 15.
Kenya, Shami Mali, India, Panya Mishra. She's currently studying electrical engineering, enjoys dancing and badminton. Mexico, Mariana Barumen Remoso, likes running and swimming and believes in being punctual and polite, has a pet parrot. Australia, Jessica Michelle Kahawati. She's doing a law degree, also works as a TV presenter, and her hobbies include skiing. Jamaica, Deanna Robbins, an environmental biology student from Kingston. She'd like to be a doctor. She enjoys tennis. People's Republic of China, Wen Xiao Yu, wants to become a music teacher, and she plays the piano. She likes hiking, and her favorite food is dumplings. Wales, Sophie Elizabeth Moulds, studying for a degree in business management. She likes to run, swim, and walk her two dogs. South Sudan, Atong Demach, studying translation. She speaks five languages already and wants to help children to a better life with education. England, Charlotte Holmes, works as a presenter, enjoys surfing and skiing, and says she loves running in marathons. She did one last year. Brazil, Mariana Notarangelo, in her fourth year at medical school, enjoys swimming, reading, and singing, has a pet dog. Spain, Aranzazu Estevez, studying for an education degree and therefore wants to become a teacher. In her spare time, enjoys sport and painting. Philippines, Queen Erich Rayman, at university she studied psychology. She says she's a quiet person but determined, and she loves the movies. United States, Claudine Book, sees herself pursuing an acting career after her studies. Like many of the girls, she loves chocolate. Netherlands, Natalie Den Dekker, studied law at university and wants to become a lawyer. She likes reading and spending lots of time with family and friends. Indonesia, Ines Ciptadi. She's from Bali and a professional golfer, the youngest and first female to win the Governor Cup. Kenya, Shamim Ali. She's studying architecture and wants to become a designer. Ladies and gentlemen, our final 15.
A beautiful sea of green there. ORDOS and Dongsheng have been magnificent hosts for Miss World 2012, but it is now time to reveal which country will host the 63rd Miss World Final.
It's all right, yeah.
Indonesia will host Miss World 2013. Oh, there you are, guys. You can certainly sign me up for that next year.
Yeah,
Jason?
I'm there. Count me in.
Handing over the flag is Mr. Ma, Vice Mayor of Dongsheng District. Receiving it, Mr. Nana Putra, Managing Director, Programming and Production from Southeast Asia Media Group, MNC.
Welcome back to Miss World. Now, for a truly special performance. The contestants have been spellbound in rehearsals by one of the leading opera stars in the world.
That's right. From the Metropolitan Opera House in New York, we are honored to present Mr. Roderick Dixon.
To care someday. Beautiful. And I have here with me Miss Shasha, who is also very beautiful. Hello, Shasha. She's from China. So what do you think of the stage? 这个舞台是不是很美啊？
当然很美了。
小时候有没有想过能登上这么美的舞台？
我想每个女孩子都有这么一个梦想。
Since she was a little girl, she's been dreamed of to be able to go up to such a beautiful stage. And among the final 15, which one is your favorite? 前十五名当中你最喜欢的是哪位？
当然是中国。
那么为她加油一下好不好？
China, 加油
Of course, Miss China, go Miss China! More results, we need more results from you. Jason, Mylene, take it away.
Thank you very much. Yes, Lily, we are trying. Now the judges have made their decision. It's time to reveal the seven finalists for Miss World 2012. In no particular order, our first finalist is...Jamaica!
Our second finalist is...South Sudan.
Our third finalist is...
Fourth finalist is... Africa. Australia.
Our fifth
fifth finalist is... Brazil!
Only two left. Our sixth finalist is... the People's Republic of China.
Just one place left. Our seventh finalist is...
Congratulations on making the Miss World final, ladies. Now, Lily, I believe you are out there somewhere with an audience member, perhaps a family member, yes, that is very excited.
Yes, we have families here. Daniel, so where are you from?
We're from Indonesia, from Bali.
So you are the cousin or a brother?
I'm the brother of Miss Indonesia.
Wow, so how many family members do we have here? How many? Wow, 20, what a big family for Miss Indonesia. So we'll see, unfortunately, she's not in the top seven right now. But Stu, what are you gonna say to your, I don't know, little sister, is that?
Yes.
Okay.
We're gonna keep supporting her. She's done a very good job. She tried her best, and we're happy for her.
Okay, and next year, Miss World is gonna be in Indonesia. You really look forward to that. So what would you really look forward to that? I mean, next year, something special about Indonesia?
We have a very vast culture and a very vast of dances and beautiful places also.
Okay, so when your little sister comes home, Daniel, what were you going to say to her? Do you have anything special, a special gift or something prepared for her?
No, just a nice big hug. That's it.
Wow, that's nice. Once again, bring up your spirits. Cheer for Miss World. Back to you. Marlene, Jason, take it away.
Thank you very much, Lily. Indonesia, see you next year. We are fast approaching the crowning of a new Miss World. Her life will change forever. Fact, as last year's winner well knows. Please, would you give a very warm welcome to our reigning Miss World, the very gorgeous Miss Ivian Sarkoz. Well, you look fabulous. Those fishtails, tricky to walk in. Now, I mentioned earlier that this is a life-changing experience. Can you tell everybody, how has it changed your world becoming Miss World?
Well, good evening, everybody. I am very nervous, it's normal. It really changed my life. I think it's the best change in my life. So I am a little, I am sad, it's normal, but I can't believe this moment has arrived.
Go on, you're doing really well, you're doing really well. It must be very emotional because I know you've had a wonderful year as Miss World. You've traveled, you were telling me you've traveled around the world, you've met so many wonderful people. What can these girls expect?
Well, it's the best experience, ladies. It's the best. The best people, Miss Julia Morley and Steve Douglas. You know, in the heart, I want to say something for Miss Julia Morley and Steve Douglas. Thank you so much for everything, for your support, for your love. You always will be in my heart.
Thank you, Miss Ivyan Sarkoz. You've been a fantastic Miss World for us, a wonderful representative. Thank you. Jason.
Thank you, Mylene. So, ladies, this is the moment. You have 30 seconds when you can explain to the judges why you should be our next Miss World. But before we do that, we're actually going to go backstage to the folks who know you the best, your roommates. Steve, are you back there?
Oh, yes, I'm back with the roommates, and are they telling me something? I'm here with Miss Ethiopia, a roommate of Jamaica. Let us know about Jamaica.
Well, I call her Dee, but most of all, she's a comedian. She can get up, or she always uses her iPod, but mostly she's like my older sister, so I learn from her a lot.
So a sleepy older sister out there with you, Jason.
Dee, is it true you're a jokester?
I didn't think I was funny, but thanks.
All right, 30 seconds for our judges.
Okay, I think the next Miss World should be someone who is hardworking, intelligent, articulate, and compassionate. I think she should embody beauty with a purpose and be actively involved in her community. I also think she should be a good role model for girls, and I strive to be that kind of person, so that is why I think I should be your next Miss World. Thank you.
Well said, Dee. Jamaica, South Sudan, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Steve, who are you with?
I'm here with Zimbabwe, South Sudan's roommate. Let us know about South Sudan.
Okay, Atong's been my roommate for a month, and she's a beautiful, charming girl with a brilliant personality, but she never gets off the phone, especially at night. I have to sometimes wait for her to finish talking with the whole family.
I think that's true of all 116 contestants, I can tell you, Jason.
Are you a bit chatty? Is this true?
I guess so.
Well, you miss your family. It's understandable.
Everyone. I never been away from my family so far, and this has been a great experience.
Nice. Now you have 30 seconds to tell the judges why you should be the next Miss World.
As a young girl growing up in a country with war, seeing my people homeless, poor, without education, and losing someone every single day, if I'm here today, it's because I've learned to take every day as a new chance to learn more, to give more, and to love more. I believe we truly make life of what we give, and there's nothing more wonderful than making a child smile and have a great hope for a better future. That's the beauty that I stand for, and it's a beauty with a purpose.
Thank you very much. Beautifully said. India, you're actually off the hook. Good evening. No more roommates. We're just going to have you speak with the judges. You have 30 seconds.
Sure. Oh, okay. Ni hao, China. I believe the next Miss World should be a woman with a kind heart, humility, who, wherever she goes, makes their people feel that she's their own. Somebody who carries simple values in this complex world, somebody who believes in herself, and this is what I believe I am. Thank you very much.
Well said, thank you. Australia, you have 30 seconds for the judges.
The Miss World crown is a symbol for fundraising. It is a tremendous gift. It is a great responsibility. That's why I think the next Miss World should be a lady with integrity, compassion, and be with the organization and with the world. I believe that it is important to learn from the wealth of knowledge from the organization, and that would be a very humbling opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Brazil?
Ni hao.
Ni hao. All right, 30 seconds for our judges.
I chose to participate in Miss World because it not values only beauty, but also how beauty can be used to help people. I'm a student of medicine, and I feel in my heart that I have to be a good person. And since I was a child, I have a dream to help and save lives. So if I win the Miss World, I will do my best to help as many as people I can.
Thank you very much.
Miss China, you have 30 seconds for our judges.
Good morning, everyone. 大家晚上好。我一直觉得自己是一个特别幸运的女孩，因为在我从小到大的成长路线当中，有很多人帮助过我。我一直觉得自己特别幸运。如果我能够成为世界小姐 Miss World， 我想通过世界小姐给我们这样的一个平台，通过自己的能力，可以去帮助更多的小朋友，让他们知道他们也是幸运的，因为有我们在他们的身边。
谢谢。
Help me when I grow up. So therefore, I think if I become Miss World, and I can use this opportunity to help more children, to help them to realize that there are people out there helping them.
Well said, Miss Wells.
Good evening, Mongolia. I strongly believe that we should use the opportunities we are given to make a positive change, not only in ourselves, but in the rest of the world. If I was lucky enough to win Miss World 2012, I would try my absolute hardest every single day to make a positive impact in as many people's lives as I possibly could. Thank you.
Well said. Well said. Thank you, ladies. All fantastic.
After the break, Miss World 2012 will be crowned. You just can't go away. Please welcome our seven finalists to the stage.
please welcome onto the stage the chairman and CEO of the Miss World organization, Julia Morley.
Hello, Julia.
Welcome.
I shall announce the results, as is customary, in reverse order. In third place, Australia. In second place, Wales. And the winner of Miss World 2012 is Republic of China.
People's Republic of China, Wen Xiaoyu, Miss World 2012. People's Republic of China, Wen Xiaoyu, is Miss World 2012. It's been a wonderful evening here in ORDOS. From all of us at Miss World, goodbye.